Welcome to Eye Care Central. This video is on the etiological classification of cataract. So cataract can be classified in two ways. There is the morphological classification, which is based on the structural characteristics of different types of cataracts. We have already discussed the morphological classification in our previous video. You can check out the link in the description box below. In this one, we will be discussing the etiological classification. Etiology means the cause of a disease. So, etiological classification is based on the different causes that may lead to the development of cataract. As we all know, the most common type of cataract that is seen is senile cataract. Senile cataract refers to a cataract that develops as part of the aging process, which usually occurs after 40 to 45 years of age. Based on the age of presentation, other cataracts that are seen are congenital cataracts that are present since birth. They can be hereditary, in that case they can be autosomal dominant, autosomal recessive, or may even show X-linked inheritance. In fact, approximately one-third of all congenital cataracts are hereditary. Congenital cataracts can also occur as part of a genetic syndrome like Lewy syndrome, which is also known as oculocerebrorenal syndrome, Down syndrome, Alport syndrome, etc. Some babies develop cataract due to an intrauterine infection contracted by the mother during pregnancy. For example, rubella and toxoplasmosis. That is the reason why we get torch titers done in all cases of congenital cataracts. Intake of certain medicines during pregnancy like thalidomide, steroids can also lead to cataract formation in the baby. Interestingly, almost 60% of all congenital cataracts don't have any identifiable etiology. Developmental or juvenile cataract develops during the first 12 years of life. The most commonly encountered developmental cataract is a zonular cataract. It is sometimes associated with rickets and hypocalcemia. Besides aging, many other factors are implicated in the development of cataract. First is trauma. Trauma is one of the commonest causes of unilateral cataract in youngsters. Traumatic cataract can develop due to both blunt trauma as well as penetrating trauma. The type of cataract typically seen in cases of blunt trauma is known as rosette cataract, because the shape of a rosette cataract resembles the arrangement of rose petals. Another morphology of cataract that is commonly seen in cases of trauma is a posterior subcapsular cataract. A term that is commonly encountered when discussing the etiology of cataract is a complicated cataract. Complicated cataract strictly refers to a cataract that develops secondary to an intraocular pathology. The various intraocular pathologies that can lead to cataract formation are uveitis, which can be an anterior uveitis or a posterior uveitis or an intermediate uveitis. Polychromatic luster is characteristically seen in complicated cataracts. Other ocular pathologies that can cause complicated cataract are high myopia, retinitis pigmentosa, retinopathy of prematurity, retinal detachment, intraocular tumors like retinoblastoma, persistent hyperplastic primary vitreous, glaucoma, etc. The cataract that is seen in glaucoma is known as glaucoma flecken. It signifies previous attacks of angle closure in the eye. Many systemic conditions are also associated with cataract formation. These can be divided into five broad categories: metabolic disorders, dermatological conditions, connective tissue or skeletal disorders, renal diseases, and CNS diseases. The first metabolic disease that comes to mind is obviously diabetes. Diabetes hastens the process of cataract formation. True diabetic cataract is known as a snowflake or a snowstorm cataract. This morphology is quite rare. It mostly occurs in young individuals with very high uncontrolled blood sugar levels. Second type of cataract that is seen in diabetics is the age-related diabetic cataract, which is very similar to a senile cataract in its morphology, but it has an earlier onset and shows a faster progression. Galactosemia is an inborn error of galactose metabolism, which occurs due to the deficiency of the enzyme galactose 1-phosphate uridyl transferase. Galactosemia typically produces an oil droplet cataract. Other metabolic diseases that are associated with cataract are hypocalcemia, hypoparathyroidism, Wilson's disease, Fabry's disease, homocystinuria, Refsum's disease, etc. Patients with Wilson's disease tend to develop a type of anterior subcapsular cataract that we know as sunflower cataract. The dermatological diseases associated with cataract formation are atopic dermatitis, Rothman's disease, Werner's syndrome, and congenital ectodermal dysplasia. These cataracts are known as syndermatotic cataracts. Musculoskeletal diseases in which cataract is often seen include myotonic dystrophy, Stickler syndrome, Weill-Marchesani syndrome, and Marfan syndrome. Marfan syndrome is typically associated with bilateral supratemporal subluxation of the lens. Christmas tree cataract is seen in myotonic dystrophy. Renal diseases associated with cataract are Lewy syndrome and Alport syndrome. Anterior lentigonus is seen in Alport syndrome, and Lewy syndrome causes an anterior capsular cataract. Cataract formation is seen in a few CNS disorders as well, like microcephaly, Little's disease, neurofibromatosis type 2, etc. Cataracts can also occur secondary to exposure to ionizing radiations, X-rays, UV rays, infrared rays, microwaves. These cataracts are usually posterior subcapsular cataracts, and they are known as radiational cataracts. Intake of certain drugs can also cause lens opacities. The most commonly implicated medications in the pathogenesis of cataract are corticosteroids. Taken in oral form, inhalational form, in the form of topical steroid eye drops, or even as topical skin ointments, steroids produce a posterior subcapsular cataract. Amiodarone is another drug implicated in cataract formation. It is an anti-arrhythmic drug that produces anterior capsular opacities. Cataract can also occur due to the use of miotics like ecothiophate and pilocarpine, antipsychotic drugs like phenothiazine, chlorpromazine being most widely used, can cause dust-like granular pattern under the anterior capsule. PUVA therapy, that is used to treat skin diseases like psoriasis and vitiligo with the help of UV radiations, has been shown to cause cataract formation in rare cases. Electric cataracts can occur following shock from a high-tension conductor, lightning, or sometimes even electric shock therapy. These are typically anterior and posterior subcapsular opacities with a fern-like appearance. It is believed to develop due to coagulation of proteins and osmotic changes following damage to the subcapsular epithelium. It usually develops 1 to 12 months after the electric shock, and the degree and progression of cataract does not depend on the strength of cataract. Now, what if a person less than 40 years of age presents with cataract but does not have any features or symptoms suggestive of these etiologies and all his investigations are found to be normal? In that case, the patient is presumed to have a presenile cataract. So, a presenile cataract is a cataract that develops in less than 40 years of age after all the other known causes of cataract have been ruled out. So, let's enumerate the different etiologies of cataract before concluding this video. Senile cataract, congenital cataract, developmental cataract, traumatic cataract, complicated cataract, cataract associated with systemic disorders like metabolic diseases, syndermatotic cataracts, musculoskeletal diseases, renal diseases, CNS diseases, radiational cataract, drug-induced cataract, electric cataract, presenile cataract. So with this, we will end this video. I understand that this was a completely theoretical topic, but you cannot skip it because in clinical practice, you never say that the diagnosis of the patient is just cataract. Cataract is a finding, it is a sign. Your diagnosis will be incomplete if you have not mentioned the etiology of that cataract. So if you found this video useful, please like it and share it with your friends and colleagues, and please subscribe to my channel to support free education. Thank you very much.